Hello guys and welcome to my channel. My name is Jesper Offersen and on this channel here we are talking about skincare, and as I normally say, I don't use a filter, so this is actually how I look. So if you saw me on the high street, you would be able to recognize me because I don't hide behind a filter here. So today we are going to talk a little bit about eyelash curlers, and we have spoken about them before and we've made various comparisons with them. So normally I would say that this one here from Shu Uemura, that is a full eyelash curler thing, because this review is going to be about the mini ones. So this one here is the one that I normally use and that I find is working the best for me. It is not perfect, but it's one I find that I maneuver the best for my eyelids. So eyelids, they come in different shapes and sizes and all that sort of thing, as a lot of other stuff does. But there is this one here from Shiseido as well, and I've tested that one also. And for me, it doesn't work that well. And I think what it is about when you want to curl your eyelashes is that you need to find the one that suits your eyelids the best. And that is not necessarily the one that is the most expensive one. Well, I would say usually some of those that are very, very cheap, they can be a little bit clumsy, and for that reason they can be maybe not that great. But as such, it's not the amount of money you spend on it, it's more like the shape of the eyelash curlers that is doing the trick. So today we are going to look at some of these mini curlers, and I have chosen three different ones. So there are these ones here. One of them is from Shu Uemura. So that is this one here is from Shu Uemura. That's the one I normally use. But then I thought I would take one of those that they call it an S curler. It says up here. And that is this sort of a mini curler here. So I thought I would try that one at least. And then I chose a Japanese one here as well. And that is from the brand Shiseido. So this is their normal one, the full lash curler one. And then they have this mini one, and it came in this sort of boring packaging. So it looks like this, and it kind of like looks very much like a mini curler actually, where some of the other curlers, they look a little bit different. As you can see, this one here looks, that's one from Shu Uemura. It looks rather strange, I would say. And we can talk about that later. So I chose this one here, Revlon. It looks like this, and it is maybe not that elegant, where maybe something like this, I mean, I wouldn't say that any of these ones are actually elegant in any way, where something like this one here, the full one from Shiseido, I would say it looks really beautiful and nice, but I would not say that about any of these ones here. So it is not a beauty contest for the eyelash mini curlers, but maybe it is a beauty contest if you are using some of these ones here, you want to look extra good. And you have that little sort of issue that when you are using something like a full-on one, so the full one, then you cannot get hold of these ones out in the corner, or they will be kind of like have a kink on the middle, and you actually want it closer to your eyelid. So you kind of like really get this sort of like a oomph effect at the outer corner. So it can also be a little bit difficult to reach those at the inner corner as well. But kind of like you can maybe try and do these ones at the inside, but then you don't get these ones out, and then you kind of like do it a second time, and it's not that great. So these mini ones here, how do they actually work? So this one, as I said, is from Shu Uemura. We have the from Shiseido, and then this Revlon one. So first up, we will just try this one on my eyelashes. And I would say, if we look at this one here from Shu Uemura, it looks rather strange. And maybe you have already noticed something a little bit strange. And that is, if you are using something like this, you would like to get very close to your eyelashes. So like where they actually start, where they grow out, because that is where you want to have the biggest lift. So this one here, if you just have a little look at it, you can see it does something a little bit strange. And that is actually that this piece here is bending sort of inwards, but it kind of like, that is when you look like this, but your eyelashes is coming from this side here. So what it means is that when you are grabbing hold of them, then actually this thing here is bending the wrong way, I would say. It should maybe, I would say, turn the other way, so you come closer to the root of your eyelashes. So then there is this, I think it's some sort of a safety thing. I actually took it off at one point and see if it was supposed to be taken off. I don't think it was. I think it is actually meant to be on some sort of a rubber hood. And you can easily take it off, but you just leave it on because I think that is how it's supposed to be. And it's sort of like supposed to cushion your eyelid or something like that. So what I would do is that I can test these ones here on one eyelash, and then we can actually, and that is what I would normally do. I would take this one here first and then just make the basic sort of curl, and then I would go in and do the extra sort of curl where I want a bit more lift. So if we just look at this one here, I'm going to try on this eyelid here, then we can see that, as I said, it is a little bit strange. So when I use it on my eyelid here, and I hope you can see that, then I will go out at the outer corner here, and already this is a small one, and yes, I have a man's hand, funnily enough, but it's, I don't have a huge hand as such, but I find that this one here is very petite. So we go in and try and grab them out here, and it is, I mean, the first issue I have here is that this one here, it actually hits up here. So it means that I cannot get close in. I might be able to get closer in the middle, but that's really not where I have the issue. I have it at the outer corner. So we try best we can. And another thing is that you obviously need, if you tilt it, kind of like if you have the eyelashes and they go like that, then you hold it like this, then you get a strange kink. So you will have to kind of like follow the eyelash line. So that is what we are trying. And it is like really, really difficult. I try the best I can, and you just hold it for a little while. And another thing is that you shall be very careful. See, I would say nothing happened here at all. So this is not great. And the thing is that you have to, and that is with all of them, apart from these ones here, which are the normal ones, they are a little bit easier. But something like this the other one, maybe not that much this one here, because it is as a normal sort of eyelash curler. But these ones here, and you can maybe already guess what I'm gonna say, and that is this part here, you should be very careful that you don't get it bunking into your eye, the eyeball. That is really a problematic. So when you're trying to maneuver this one here, it may be that this one is stopping the whole thing from coming too close in, but then you might go like bend it a little bit, then you will hit your cheek with this one. So really, I would say I know there will be people that have longer eyelashes than I have, but definitely there are people that are having shorter eyelashes than I have, and I think you will simply not be able to use this whatsoever. It is just really, really problematic. I mean, it's definitely not gonna work. I've tried it several times. I'm just thinking, have they tried it themselves? I don't think so, but I guess they have. So that leaves us with this one here, because that you might think is great, because it kind of like really looks like something that you can relate to, something you have seen before. The thing is, of course, that it has these minor ones here, these things on the side. And what that means is that when you try and use it on your eyelashes, you might just have bent them with something like this. And then it kind of like looks okay and just want to have a little bit of a lift out here. So you would be going in with this one here, and what will happen is that this part here, on this side here, will somehow need to go in between the eyelashes that you have just made an effort to make kind of like look nice. So you will be going in, and then this simply is it will grab hold of a little bit of the eyelashes, but this is not gonna work. And I was actually thinking afterwards, is this for dolls or something like that? Or maybe it is for babies that are going to these baby beauty contest things that you hear about in America. Well, that's where I hear about them from. I think maybe this is made for dolls or very small people, or maybe for pets. It may be, but I don't actually think so. So this one here, I was just like, no, this is it is not well thought through, I think. So what I will do now is that I will try and show you this one here, and just you can see how it works compared to the other ones. And then we will go in and with this one here, and then do it on this eyelash here, and then I will just give it a little bit of an extra lift with this one here. But what I will do as well is that I will give it a little bit of some heat with a hairdryer. So you can just use a hot water if you are in the bathroom. I'm not in the bathroom now, so I'll be using a hairdryer, and you need to be careful that it's not too hot. And one thing is that if you put it under the hot water, then you have to dry it off, because if you put it onto your eyelashes and it is wet, your eyelashes will be relaxed, so it's not gonna bend. So we just have a little look and see how this one is actually performing as well. And again, you have to be very careful with this piece here. So we try out here, and again have to angle it, so it really is difficult. I touch my eye there. Yes. And maybe here you can see that I am actually rather close to my eyelashes, the roots of them, so they kind of like, you get hold of them very nicely. So I just give them a kink and then outwards like that, and you can see they lift a lot more. But when I apply some heat to it, it will be a lot more. We can just give it a little bit more, but definitely this one here is the absolute best of these ones here. And the interesting thing is that price wise it is the cheapest. So the other ones are much more expensive, these ones here. So these are Japanese ones, and this one here from Revlon, it is by far the cheapest. So what we'll be doing now is that I will use the eyelash curler that I normally use, and that's the one from Shu Uemura. I can already feel when I'm just blinking with my eyes that the eyelashes are actually kind of like touching up here, so it tells me that I have bent them rather a lot already. But now we're going for this one here, so we'll just heat them up a little bit. Whereas this is metal, this is now really, really hot actually. It will take on heat very quick. So we go in, out, it is a bit hot, and I will go in to make it nice to the inner corner, because I'm gonna grab the outer ones in a moment with the one from Revlon. So basically just as you're curling your eyelashes with, if you were using some heat, like doing it for your hair as such. And then voila. And I like to hold them up a little bit to help them as they cool off. So like that, they go up rather a lot. So we will now be going in. I could just show you that if I used this one now, I will be damaging what I have just done. So this is a no-go. And then there is this, I would say, crazy one. I really can't imagine it's going to work for anyone, but maybe it will for some. So we will be going in with this one here, and we've just heated up. So now we have to just... Yeah, that's definitely hot. So... I think I got it there. I'll just hold it for a little while. Voila. Like that, and hold it up. You get a really nice curl out to this side here. I just noticed, I think I actually shed a hair like that. So obviously this is looking a lot more dramatic than if I was just doing it on the other side without the heat on. So we just as a comparison, just we'll do this one. This is now being cold again, so just use it as it is cold, and you can just see the difference. So you can see it grabs hold of my eyelashes actually rather well, I would say, and that's why I prefer this one here from Shu Uemura. But now it is cold, so it won't be so dramatic. Well, actually it looks kind of like okay, but usually it won't last that long. And then this one here is cold. Like that. And tilt it outwards. Like that. So yeah, as you can see, it's kind of like, it looked nice just to begin with, but I can see already because it wasn't hot, it won't hold the curve. So here the eyelashes are curved a lot more. So here they are starting to kind of like come down again. And another thing is that now I have dark eyelashes, so I would not really put any sort of a mascara on. It would be, it's not my style. But if you are choosing to put a mascara on because you don't have dark color for your eyelashes or something like that, or just want to elongate them a little bit more, then I would say go in with something that is waterproof, because if you go in with something that is a normal water-soluble one, then you will actually just relax the eyelashes again, because you're adding water to the eyelashes and it will just kind of like droop down again. But then the trick, as I've spoken about before, is that when you have put on the mascara, you can actually go in afterwards and with the eyelash curler, so this one, or you can go in with this one here, but usually it was kind of like a stick to the stuff the mascara has just put on. So if you heat it up and you take it off while it is relatively hot, you are not running the risk that it will be sticking into the mascara. So yes, that is how I do it. I can just give it a little bit more if I like. I think it looks like I have sort of naturally curved eyelashes, but I can try and make a little bit more maybe not that naturally looking. So just heat it up a little bit more. So now it's definitely hot. Really careful. Oh. Yeah. Oh. Oh. Like that. It is definitely hot. Wow. Can I come a little bit closer? And actually what you can do, you can go all the way over if you want that. I have actually thought about that. That might be a lot better. I did that the other day and it was actually rather amazing. So, like that. And the inner corner as well. Voila, like that. And I kind of like it, really, really makes a lot of a difference. And this one here is really easy to go in with again without just like a. You can pinpoint where you would like to go with this one here. Definitely this one from Revlon, that is definitely the one I would choose over these Japanese ones. So the Shu Uemura one and the Shiseido one. I would say they are very expensive for, I mean, I feel they are doing absolutely nothing for me. This one here from Revlon is absolutely the cheapest one. I think it was less than £10 or something like that, 8 or 9, something like in that range. And I would say definitely it's... it's really kind of like, do I need these normal ones anymore? I actually don't think, because this one here is actually really rather great. So yes, that was my verdict. Out of these ones here, these three ones here, I would say definitely this one from Revlon, that is my preferred one. It is it's amazing if you ask me. So yes, that was my little verdict out there in these mini curlers. So if you'd like to buy one that is really great, I would say go for this one, definitely. So, if you'd like to see more of this sort of videos, please subscribe, hit the bell, and do other things I'm doing, or to be notified when I upload more of this sort of videos. Thank you for watching, see you, bye!